Miari, kena usakasakabo, ona y buenos días, hello and good day. It's Elba again, aka Phoenix Taino, playing some more Wakfu.
All right, y'all. This is another video from that time I was playing and didn't realize that my mic was off. So this video is going to be me just going through my items, organizing stuff, switching through my different characters, and doing a bunch of solo fighting. Eventually, I realized that when you switch characters or tunes, they are going to be at the last location where you played with them as. So I start switching characters and moving them all to the same spot. That way, I don't have to worry about remembering where the heck I was and all of that. What I'm doing now is tinkering around in the chat because when I was co-oping with Michi, she showed me that there are different sections and that I can kind of reduce all of the conversation happening if I deselect those that aren't relevant to me. For example, I'm not a member of a guild, so it doesn't make sense for that to be selected. I don't concern myself with PvP at the moment because I'm still, learning how to play the game. Deselected that. And when it comes to recruitment, people will organize runs even outside of their guild. So they might be like looking for a craw level 30 or higher for, our party to go on this adventure or quest or what have you. And I'm not doing that either, so I deselected that as well. Another thing that I learned from Nietzsche is to lock my haven bag if I don't want other players to be able to access it. Unfortunately, this game kind of gives you some basics when you play, but there are things that you either need to figure out on your own, look up on Google or in community message boards. And in my case, I'm lucky enough to know somebody who has played this game before, so I can just ask them. My goal now is to get all of my toons to level 10 or higher, because the Celestial Island of Re is for characters that are level 1 to 10, and you really have no other reason to come back to this area unless you have to interact with certain ghosts or gods, or there are materials that you need to collect to be able to craft certain items. Here I am basically looking at the different spells that I've unlocked and deciding whether or not I want to move the ones that are currently selected around, add a new one, da 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 da. Then I do a bunch of battles with all the different wodents, which are the bunny rabbit looking creatures, and that takes a good bit of time. So I'm just gonna skip over that and move on to the next phase of my character development.
20 minutes later.
Here, I'm realizing that because all of the characters share certain things, it would behoove me to take the time and go to all of the Drago Express creatures in Astrub. That way, as I am getting through the different quests, I can teleport more easily to the next place that I need to go.
Thank you.
Once I get done activating all of the Draco Express locations or touching all the travel turkeys, I decided that I would switch back to Watuyanani so that I could get a better handle on the Sedita.
A few moments later.
So after all of these different battles and testing out moves without having to worry about dying before I can figure out what does what, I decide to see how I hold up against higher level monsters. So that's what you're about to see me do. After doing a couple of one-on-one battles with different gobbles, because they had me traumatized from dying so often when I was co-oping with Nietzsche, I felt confident enough to progress the story of this world. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and cut this video off here. I hope y'all enjoyed watching and that you come back for more.